Hey guys, good afternoon. Happy 2022. Happy New Year, guys. Happy New Year. Happy New Year to my 86 subscribers. I know say we never plenty, but for those people that have stuck with me through 2021, thank you so much. That 86 subscribers, and it means a lot to me, because even if it was one subscriber I had, for the fact that I know that someone is watching and might be inspired or might have learned something from me from the year 2021 since I started my YouTube channel journey, thank you so much. Happy New Year, guys. So if this is the first time, please do not forget to subscribe, like, and comment. I know you already know what I was gonna say. Yes. So today, in the spirit of New Year, I'm just gonna talk about family. Not really family, I'm not gonna bore you, but I made a decision and I want to be sure that I am not being too strict in my parenting. As you already know, I have 3 kids. I know everybody say I should keep saying it. Yes, I'm proud of having them. So yeah, I have 3 kids and the last one is 3 years old. So here's the problem. Whenever they go to their grandma's house, they like to use her phone and they use it to the level that they spoilt it. Yes, and to be honest, I got embarrassed to some level because I personally don't give them my phones. I know people keep saying, oh, you're too strict. I don't think I'm too strict, but I just have certain rules that I believe should be put in place. So I do not give them my phone because I believe that, okay, there's cartoon in the house, there's TV, and so you're already watching cartoon. Why do you need to use games? And I know I bought, you know, there's a ball in the house, there are little games that they play, you know, with their siblings. So why do you need to use the phone? But because I saw that whenever they meet anyone, they'll be like, can I please use your phone? I started to get embarrassed and I said, okay, maybe I should buy them a pad, which I did. But what I did was buy them a pad, just one pad. So when I bought that pad, I told them that, you see, I'm going to give it to you guys with the option that you are not going to fight and you're going to, you know, be amicable, try and not quarrel and know how to sort yourselves out. But all I know is you people must manage this one pad. So now, keep in mind that the first one is 7, the second one she's 6, and this little one is 3. Now, the first one loves to watch wrestling. The second one is obviously a girly girl, Barbie, Cinderella, all girly stuff, Sophia the First. The last one loves Peppa Pig, Paddington, and you already know Baby Shark and all that. So, now, it's obvious, before I even gave them to the pad, I already knew that there was definitely going to be a problem. So, but I gave it to them anyway, and I said, okay, they should sort it out. So yes, as you have assumed, there was always going to be fights because 3 of them have different kind of things that they want to watch because they're in different age groups. The worst part is the girl. You know, the little boy might decide to, okay, let me watch wrestling with my first brother, but the little girl in the middle does not want any form of violence. She doesn't like to see violence. She doesn't like to see anything. I mean, she decided that she doesn't want to be a doctor by just watching an episode from what they call that doctor show, because she saw blood. You get so now here's the problem. Their dad came and he said, okay, what he's going to do is that, okay, I'm going to give you money so that you buy 2 extra pads so that there will not be problem. And I agreed. But the next day, when I decided that I was going to buy the pad, I changed my mind and I gave him back the money. I said, you see this money, I'm going to use it to do something different for myself or for them, but I'm not going to buy 2 pads. And he said, okay. So now, a few friends of mine and some close people, and I say, ah, Rookie, we feel like you're being too strict with your parents. Why do you think that they shouldn't have it all? And here is my reason. We live in an era where everyone is pressing their phones. When you go to a family house, you see that both husband and wife are sitting in the dining table, but they are pressing their phones. No lengthy conversation is happening. Nobody is fighting. Nobody is quarreling over phones. Nobody is doing anything. And I feel like we miss, because of that, we miss the togetherness that we used to have. Call it anything, call it that, because one of my friends said I'm living in the 1950s, whatever. But I believe in togetherness. I believe in having conversation. I want my kids to have memories of them quarreling over little things. I want them to be able to quarrel over toys, quarrel over the choice of cartoon. But that sticks them together, and that makes me happy. Now, do you think that that's making me an overly strict mother? Do you think I should have got them 3 pads and then all of them will just be in each corner? Maybe all of them will be in their rooms and they will not even see themselves because they are busy pressing their phones. I don't think that way, but I would love to know if I am being too strict. But to be honest, my reason is I want them to be together. And you know, funny enough, now they know how to, you know, share it. Now Musti goes to the parlor and watches cartoon. The little brother takes the pad while the sister goes to the other room to watch her Sophia. Sometimes they decide to come together while one person would play the game and two of them watch together. And that is what I was looking for. And to be honest, they're already making it work. But if you feel like I'm being too strict, please let me know down in the comment section. I really want to know. I really want to know, and I want you to give me your reasons why you think I'm being too strict. So thank you so much for listening to my rant today. It's still your girl, Rukinupe OG. I'm going to be posting videos back to back. I'm going to give you people left, right, center in this 2022. So be ready and brace yourselves. Thank you so much for listening to me. I love you all. Bye.